couple years ago. I said, oh, would it be a great idea to get an ice rink on the common? Well, we investigated that last year, and the common really isn't level enough, coupled with the fact that there's no lights. The logical place to put it was where it is now, which is the basketball courts. And I didn't realize it, but ironically, that several years ago, almost 30 years ago, they used to flood the basketball courts and have an ice rink, but for whatever reason, they stopped doing it. So we started to work with the schools last year to go ahead and investigate the possibility, and we kind of ran out of time. So this year, we're able to go ahead and have the rink professionally installed. The materials we'll be able to use from year to year. And we'll see how successful it is. So the thought is the rink would be used after school hours from 2 to, say, 10 because of the lights. And it'll be free to open skate. So we're not encouraging, you know, we're not allowing sticks and pucks for the fear that, you know, some of that play will get in the way with the free skaters. But it's a park and rec project. And it's been done in conjunction with, it's kind of a nice community effort, because it's been done in conjunction with the school's building and grounds department, the water authority, and the Kenny Carter fire chief to fill it, the DPW to kind of help oversee it as well. And then we've arranged for Mike Wayland, who's a longtime town resident, to kind of help maintain it when it snows.